I'm a medical doctor by training, so I would also like to speak a little bit about resilience of mind, because that has been a major, major issue. And, you know, that's an area that never gets covered. So I'll talk about two things. One, of course, that, you know, while the changes that we've done should remain and should be sustainable. So we're taking a conscious effort and, you know, so I'll talk about this in three levels. So at the level of the management where we all are, we have now ensured that there will always continue to be optimal use of technology. Which what does this mean? Which means that if, you know, Maharashtra government and, you know, other, of course, we have campuses in other states where they already opened up. But when the government allows all the students to come in, and when we come to a kind of a normal that we were in 2019, even then we'll continue in the blended mode and not really switch over totally to face-to-face, because you never know what will happen when. And we don't want the same reaction as what happened in the March of 2020. And therefore, you know, we are doing a hell lot of training. We are spending a lot of resources on training of teachers, and taking them, you know, to levels much higher than what they were when the pandemic started, when it was, you know, just online teaching, to using newer pedagogies, to newer engagement strategies with students. And it isn't just about teaching, Sudhakarji. It's about so many other things. Like, I'll just give you an example of a topic, again, very close to my heart, internationalization. I mean, right now, through the pandemic, we're seeing so many foreign teachers in classrooms that they wouldn't have otherwise come. And this was because, obviously, because of online education. So can we still continue to engage with these foreign teachers and continue, you know, this whole process of internationalization is something that we're looking. We never, ever gave, you know, virtual internships to our foreign students. In fact, most of the foreign students always complain that, you know, they don't get to work in Indian companies. They don't get to intern in Indian companies because of, you know, the government restrictions. But now, you know, even companies are coming forward to give them e-internships. Now, can you continue with those virtual internships? So a lot of innovative things that happened because of this word e, and, you know, the online part and the virtual part. And we wish to continue this. So this is the management's approach. And therefore, you know, the amount of resources that we would otherwise have spent or earmarked for, you know, for physical infrastructure, we've diverted a lot of those for, you know, obviously technology. Phenomenally got raised, obviously, and we'll continue those for times to come. So this is part one. Part two is teacher training, as I said, and our Teaching Learning Resource Center at Symbiosis will continue with the kind of faculty development programs that otherwise would happen now, obviously virtual ones, now more focus on technology usage, so on and so forth. Third is, of course, students. And I think that's the larger cohort that we have, the largest stakeholders, and we need to satisfy them with the kind of engagement that we do. And with the restrictions, even when campuses open up, you know, that I'm sure in no class there would be 100% students allowed, you know, to sit in class so close to each other. And therefore, this whole blended education for them to get used to being evaluated through technology are things that, you know, will continue to happen, so that it's not something that we started and ended just because, you know, campuses have now opened up. We wish to continue them, and more importantly, of course, school. Now, coming to the other part of it. So I think the resilience of the mind is most important, Sudhakarji, you know, to adapt to a new normal and continue, you know, that whole phase. When, you know, for students, it is that they're not meeting their peers, not meeting their friends, sitting at home. For some of us, working from home is not something that we enjoy doing, but we had to do that. And surprisingly, we did a little research internally within, you know, the responses that we got from women staff. We did some research on work from home amongst women staff, and surprising findings. In fact, I as a woman thought that many of them will be happy to work from home, you know, being with their family and so on. But the large response was that they wanted to come back simply because, you know, they felt that that's not the way they should continue to work. And they wanted to meet their peers, colleagues, etc. So, you know, we're also looking at flexible timings for women, for men, of course, and looking at how can we continue this whole concept of work from home, if not the way we did it last time, but at least, you know, the giving them the flexibility to do so, because now we are confident. We are confident that the output is the same. At times, in fact, it's more, you know, so giving them that comfort of flexible timings is something, again, that, you know, we've seen. Again, the mental health issues of students. So the Symbiosis Center for Emotional Well-being has dealt with these issues so well, I would say, that there were almost 20,000 students that consulted our counselors. We have counselors on all our campuses. We have a very strong emotional well-being center that supports students. But you'll be surprised to know that the kind of consultations that happened during this lockdown period were much more than what happened in the past when, you know, students were on campus, which means that this support can still continue. And, you know, we need to take care of not just the physical health, because our university is a health promoting university, but even the mental health of our students, and more important, should be given to them to develop this resilience. So we've taken a lot of webinars on resilience, not just for students, but even their parents, because, you know, parents are also not used to having their children at home. You know, they are also not very happy having so, you know, for such a long time. And therefore, the kind of conflict that, you know, many of them have faced between, you know, parents and their children is something that we are trying to talk to them about. So I suppose, you know, it's COVID has taught us much more than what we would have expected. And I just hope that this learning that we've learned out of a very deadly disease, I, as a doctor, I feel that we need to continue this. And it has certainly strengthened us both physically and, more importantly, mentally. Thank you.